Hey, this is Tom Hazard from Ellison, and you're watching CMS TV.
And we are back right here on Chris Aker Presents. That was fun, Eric.
That was a lot of fun.
She's great. She's
making
great.
Me feel a little old.
I do gotta admit that. I definitely feel old when I'm more than twice their age.
When you ask like how old their dad is, and it's like he's
younger than me. Us.
I was also considering that, like, in the time that I've played for Stephen Piercy, the 22 years or whatever, you could actually grow an entire human being.
Yeah.
In that time. You could literally grow it from birth to adulthood and teach them everything there is to know about music in that time.
I know. It's crazy.
And it's like, ugh.
I know. Dude, we're old. I hate to admit it, but we are old.
Right.
We are definitely old, but it's, I'm, and this is not a secret. I don't care who fucking gives me the groupie tag that I've been wearing about Plush. I love the band. I love the band. I'm happy to see them doing well. I do text back and forth with Mariah on occasion, and I consider her to be a friend, and I'm happy for them. It's very weird. I'll tell you why this is weird for me. Because I've never known anybody that wasn't famous that became famous.
Right.
And I'm watching it happen. And it's very interesting to me to watch this person that I knew that was doing gigs at the, you know, the neighborhood bar during the pandemic. And that's how not long ago this really was. Mariah was doing solo acoustic gigs for Venmo tips during the pandemic.
Wow.
And now Plush is toured with Seven Dust, Slash, Alice in Chains, Hailstorm, Evanescence, Wolfgang Van Halen, Daughtry. It's
right.
It's like, wow. And Mariah's in TSO now. It's like, holy fuck. How did that happen in such a short amount of time?
Right. Well, she's a monster vocalist.
Yeah, she is a monster.
Apparent watching the covers that made her go viral, you know, that we all saw, which were really amazing.
Yeah.
It's interesting to me, like, the voice that they settle on, you know, for themselves after covering some of these other bands so well.
Mm-hmm.
Then the natural voice isn't like necessarily like those other artists, you know, she's right. Finding her own voice. I mean, but what I've heard, I mean, they could definitely be the next Evanescence, you know.
They certainly could. Yeah, they're a little heavier than that.
Right.
They are definitely a little bit heavier than that, but they're well on their way. I mean, and again, this is me waxing poetic here. I hope they get picked up. Nothing against Pavement at all. Pavement is great. And they are a super company. And I know a bunch of people over at Pavement and they're awesome. I just don't know that they have enough push, enough. I don't know that they have enough money to get Plush to the next level. I almost think Plush needs to sign with a Jason Flom or somebody like that, whoever's the current Jason Flom type of a guy. That
Jason, I don't even know who that is. What is
you'll
that?
Know, he was a major A&R guy for Atlantic and like a major guy that took or like a John Kalodner type person or somebody like that, or you know, somebody that some or Rick Rubin, you know, somebody that could produce them, but at the same time just would be involved just to push them to the next. To the next stage, because they're musically they're there. Musically,
Mariah writes these songs. For what we can ascertain here,
well,
she's the driving force of the songwriting.
I think so. Far. Yeah, I mean,
and that's going to mature. That's going to continue to get better.
As I've said to Mariah, I said this to her the last time I interviewed her. You can go back and look at it. It's actually funny. I said to her, I said, the only thing I could tell from the way you write is that you're a terrible dater. Because every song she writes is about fucking heartbreak. And I'm like, you're 21 years old. know, how do you have this much heartbreak at 21?
I know. I think I dated my first girlfriend for like 5 years at that point.
That's just craziness. But yeah, I'm happy to see them doing well. And, you know, Godspeed, you know, they're doing headlining dates, and that's good. And hopefully they get a headlining tour at some point together instead of, that's the only thing I'm watching that. And again, this is me being in the business too long, but I'm watching the dates and they're all over the place. And it's just, you know, they're grabbing skag dates here and there instead of a management company or a tour management company routing, you know, 30 shows in 45 days or something. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Which is what a young man needs.
We didn't really find out exactly how they hooked up all those amazing shows that they played on. But I mean, that's really impressive. Obviously her notoriety from those cover videos plus,
well, and she was on The Voice. And she was on The Voice. Voice. Yeah. Right. So I mean, Mariah has a lot of notoriety. She's on The Voice. Michael Sweet found her at some point and put her on one of his albums. And she's sang for Striper at some point. So there's like pictures, there's video of her singing To Hell with the Devil with Striper. Mm-hmm. she's got that cred. I don't know this, and I wasn't going to ask Bella this because I know she can't answer it, but I wonder if the reason they don't have those same gigs that they had last year this year is because Brooke, who was the former drummer,
mm-hmm.
like I said, she's massive on social media.
Okay.
Like, she's huge on social media.
As far as doing drum videos and stuff like
that? Yeah, her drum video, but every one of her drum... It.
Pull up something. We have to, once in a while, when we're talking about this. Yeah, let's look at some of these things we're talking about.
YouTube.
This is a Brooke. We'll pull up a Brooke drum video or something.
Of course, we're pulling up the X player in the band. We just had the band on, so now we bring up the X player. Let's see.
Brooke. Well, you said she's huge. I haven't seen her. I just wanted to, for me and anybody watching the show that doesn't know.
Let's find a drum video of hers. Here we go.
And you could tell us how many views it has or...
Yeah.
How many followers?
Well, I'll tell you in 1 second here. Here we go. Why don't I have any sound? Here we go. This is definitely not the best video I could have pulled up.
Right. Because she's just doing a Brooke Assault song.
So. She has 317,000 followers. She's huge on social media.
It just makes it, those are like, well, I don't, you know, it's a lot of pervy dudes or like what?
Well, she is gorgeous. There's no doubt about that. She's a very good looking girl.
Yeah. I guess, yeah, people just see it.
But she does all sorts of different styles, too. Yeah, okay, here it is. I didn't realize I was still on the screen. But here's her doing Black Sabbath. She can play, man.
Yeah. She's solid and has a really good meter, that's for sure.
And now let me find a Faith Powell. Faith Powell.
Who also probably does a bunch of drum videos. Because it sounds like that's how people are getting discovered these days off their cover videos.
Yeah, let's see here. Where's me a Faith drumming video? I'm not finding any Faith. It doesn't look like she does a bunch of drumming videos, actually. Oh, I could play her playing Barracuda, though. Because she's just a different, like, when I show you this.
More showy?
Yeah, just more. She beats the drums a lot harder. I don't know how else to describe this. but she, I mean, she's just a harder player.
An M3.
There's Bella rocking out.
Yeah.
Is that a Prince guitar?
What, Mariah's?
No.
Bella's. Where do you see Bella?
She was over to the left.
Okay.
Hey, that's her, right?
Yeah, that's her. No, that's Ashley.
Oh, it is? Oh.
That's Ashley over there. I think. No, that's Bella. You're right.
Yeah.
I'm going to disagree with Joe Rico here. Joe Rico says Brooke C is a better drummer. I'm not thinking so. She's a different drummer. She may be a better technical drummer, but for this band, she's not a better drummer.
And Joe, keep in mind that we were watching Brooke play at home, and she could have filmed herself playing that 20 times before she had.
Well, and I mean, I've seen Brooke live twice. I saw her playing with Plush. Well, let me find. Let's see. I'll play Barracuda, Plush, Brooke.
This is fascinating.
Oh, watching all this with the...
Who did it better?
Who did it better?
Joe Rico might be honest.
You think she's a better drummer?
I don't. I can't say that. We made sad bad Bella on here.
My fucking.
I don't know. Acting up. They're both great. They both get awards, participation awards.
Let me see if I can find a better video. My computer's acting all goofy with that video. Well, here's Brooke. Here's the band. They did a cover of the Alter Bridge song, Isolation.
All right.
I just want to be clear. We'll play a little more of this in a minute.
Mm-hmm.
I am not. I'm seeing these comments. Brooke has better clock. Brooke has better technique. And that may all be true. I'm not by any means saying that Brooke is not a great drummer. I want to be very clear on that. I think she's a great drummer. I don't think she was the right drummer for what this band is trying to do. I think Faith is much more of a bombastic player, which is the direction that they're going as a band. That's the thought. That's my thought anyway.
Is that what, so what did happen? Did I miss that during the interview?
No, they won't talk about it.
They won't talk about it.
They don't talk about it at all. No one has mentioned.
We're going to be left guessing.
I've heard rumor, but I don't know it to be true.
Well,
the rumor that I've heard, and I'll tell the rumor again. It's just a rumor.
Whisper it.
The rumor that I heard.
What did you hear, Chris?
I heard that there was a money holdout on one of the tours.
Oh, yeah.
And they said, okay. And then they replaced the money holdout.
Oh, I see somebody. Oh, okay.
That's what I heard was I want more of a percent or
mm-hmm.
I'm not going to be showing up for Alice in Chains.
Right.
And guess what? You didn't show up for Alice in Chains.
I don't know if that's true.
I have no idea if that's true, but
man, most of the bands that are known that I've played in that exact mm-hmm. problem happened.
Yeah.
That's why my departure happened.
let me say this part though, because I know what people, the dopes that watch me, will say. I did not get that from Mariah. No. What I got from Mariah was, I'm not going to talk about that. Okay. But right. I
still consider them to be a new band trying to break in. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if I was being a part of something, I wouldn't be expecting that the same amount of money as I would playing for an established band or a band that's already worked up their guarantees to a certain amount. But on the other side of that, I don't know what these ladies were getting paid to go out on these things, or how, if their families are helping to support them. In my situation, living in California and supporting myself, one band that comes to mind, the band Earshot, if anybody remembers them, I got hired to be in that band, and it took about a week before I realized that he intended to pay me about $30 a night to play. So they got two of these. You know what I mean? I was subsequently sent home within 2 weeks, and I was like, I don't care what you're paying the other guys. I'm not going to play for that.
Yeah, not, you know, for $30. And,
no, I mean, it was like $300 a week playing five, six shows a week.
Yeah.
You know, like, fuck that. You know what I mean? I'm sorry to stand up for myself, but I mean, I had rent and bills at home, and you know, you can't treat a band like that. If you already have a name and you're at least getting a certain amount, you're not going to hold on to anybody that's worth a shit. Exactly. So I don't even know what happened to that band, but I'm sure word got out that he ain't paying shit.
And, right.
You know, nobody worth anything probably played for them.
That's right.
And Bow Wow Wow was peanuts too. It wasn't that bad, but it was still peanuts. And then when it's like a couple weeks go by, it's like, hey, when are you paying us, man? You know, you start to sniff the trouble in that market, and I get nervous because I do this for a living. I mean, there are certainly musicians out there that money is not important to them. You know what I mean? They either have their own money or they're able to do their career remotely. It doesn't affect it. They're just doing it for the glitz of playing. I mean, there are people like that, and please call them, because I'm not one of them.
Exactly.
I have fucking bills to pay, and I expect a certain amount of money, and that's,
of course.
Yeah. At the same time, and this is not just in the music world, but in the corporate world, when you get around our age, you find that that's the case in all facets of work. You know, once you hit 50, you've worked up a certain salary, you expect a certain amount, and they've already grown another human being that's half your age.
Yeah, exactly.
Half as much. You're like, fuck.
Yeah. So, I love this comment here. 19 years old and fighting over money already. They won't last. Well, it wasn't four of them fighting over money. It was just one. Allegedly. And that one was replaced.
I'll tell you, if these girls have 300,000 followers, they're making money.
They don't need
right to... now just off their videos. I mean, here we're, you know, talking about, you know, our show or other podcasters out there that have, you know, a few thousand subscribers. Yeah. These girls have 300,000.
Well, not all of them.
Right.
I do want to be clear on that. Not all of them, just Brooke. I think Mariah.
Well, Mariah must have her own channel
Not nearly as much.
And she might not be able to put stuff on her channel, right?
She's got all her stuff on there.
Is she able to even put that on? She would be demonetized for that.
No, it's on there. Okay. Here's her channel. I mean, well, let's go to her channel and see.
Is there a clip of Mariah when she was on The Voice?
Let's see. Present. Share screen. This is Mariah's channel. And she has 31,000 subscribers.
That's still...
That's a lot, but that's not 300,000.
Right.
I'm looking to see if there's any of this from The Voice.
What are the views on these videos? Look pretty good, I'm sure, huh?
About 55,000, 8,000, 51,000, 106,000. But there's the 106,000 is with Brooke.
Right. They teamed up together.
Yeah. 330. This is the one, the 313,000, the one with her singing the Steelheart tune. You've heard that, right?
That was, I think, my introduction to her, because that song in particular has the end part is just ridiculously high. I don't know how that guy pulled that off, but, and she was the only other human being on this planet that could sing it.
Yeah. Yeah. No, you're right. None of the voice stuff is on here.
Yeah, I don't think you could just go and put up stuff like that. Maybe a lot of her bigger stuff, she doesn't have the rights to it to even put it up.
Yeah,
just
keeps, which could keeps, be.
Keeps the stuff she has the stake in.
Yeah, it could be, but...
And there's
Let's play a little of this. I'll go to the end. Hey.
Let me get my glass out of the room so it doesn't shatter.
Really? That's fucking ridiculous.
Yeah, girl.
That is ridiculous.
I felt like she was telling me she'd never let me go.
Yeah, you wish.
I was kind of wish. Oh, wait. Well, I just woke up.
Yeah, just she's sitting there on a stool, too.
I know. It's usually you have to stand up to project like that out of your diaphragm. Well, you usually don't even sing right when you're sitting down.
Even Menajevic, when you watch him do it live, he almost has to take like a running start to get to that note.
He actually punches himself in the balls right before that last
he
line.
He does not. He might have needed to in the studio, but he, you know, he's, hey, let's hope that guy's doing all right, too. He had a fucking stroke here in the last, like, couple of weeks.
Like a Pfizer stroke or like one of like mine?
Like a stroke stroke.
No, like he had a blood clot or something?
I don't know. I don't know what it was. They didn't really say. It just said that he's recovering from having a stroke.
Oh, well. Prayers to him, man.
Yeah, I hope he's doing. He's a nice guy. I chatted with him during the demi-dem, and you know, he nice guy, really nice guy.
Yeah,
like that guy. All right, let me tell one quick story, and then we'll get the fuck out of here.
Okay.
So today I went over. I have to do banking on Mondays.
All right.
So I go out. I go out to the bank, and then I was like, it was fucking noon. I was like, I'm going to run over to McDonald's. I'm going to go get me a chicken sandwich. All right. Not the healthiest choice in the world, but so what? I wanted a chicken sandwich. So I go over to McDonald's. I go through the fucking drive-thru.
You always get fucked at the drive-thru.
Well, I did today. I go through the drive-thru. I order my chicken sandwich value meal for $9 or whatever it fucking is now. You know, chicken sandwich, orange Fanta, and a thing of fries. You know, Johnny Healthy here.
Do you want to Fanta, Fanta? Do you like to Fanta?
I wish they should have sang to me because I was so mad by the end of this. It wasn't even funny. So I go through, I pay my money. I get this, which always pisses me off. Always. Sir, can you pull around to the front and we'll bring it out to you?
Fuck you. I'm waiting right here and everybody else can wait too.
I should have done that today. Instead, I said, sure, no problem. Pull around to the front of the fucking building.
Hope you're not busy for the next 30 minutes.
40.
Oh, fuck that.
40. I'm sitting there. The guy keeps coming to my thing. Did you order the chicken nuggets? No. I ordered a chicken sandwich. Okay. 2 minutes later, another guy. Did you order the McDouble? No. Chicken sandwich. Eight times they come to my fucking car not with my food.
Ricky Retardo?
No, yeah, no lie. 37 minutes. I looked at the receipt. I look at the receipt. I get fucking pissed off. I drive back around because I'm tired of sitting here after 30 fucking minutes and watching every car behind me getting their food. Clearly, they fucking forgot about me.
Right.
So I pull back around. I go, you know how they have two windows, the pay window and the food window. Go to the pay window. I said, this guy's never brought me my fucking food. I can't help you. Not. Let me get a manager, nothing. Just, I can't help you. Pull up to the next fucking window. fine. Now I'm really angry. Pull up to the fucking front window. I say, here's my receipt. I didn't get my food. You guys never brought it to me. He looks at the receipt. He goes, yeah, we did.
Oh.
I was like, you didn't bring me my fucking food. And so then all of a sudden, then the manager pops up. And the manager's like, let me take care of this. Let me take care of this. Manager takes the receipt. So now I don't have a receipt. Now I'm like, fucking pissy. Closes the window. The manager walks away. 2 minutes later, the kid comes up to the window and goes, I need you to pull around to the front.
Oh, here we go again.
I was like, nope, not doing it. Not fucking. And he's like, no, no, you have to pull. I was like, I don't have to do anything.
Right.
Bring me my fucking food. And that by now I'm cussing, and they probably fucking rub
people
their
are
dicks
honking behind you.
And they probably rub their dicks on my fucking chicken at this point. But I didn't care. I was so fucking mad. Finally, the manager brings me the food. And he goes, I'm really sorry about this. It shouldn't have taken this long. I couldn't control the kids today. That's what he said to me. I couldn't control the kids today.
The kids, they have work in there. Yeah.
You're the fucking manager. Manage. You're in the store. Manage. Hey, dumb fuck number one, go put that shit in a bag. Dumb fuck number two, push that shit out the door.
Like everything you mentioned should only taken about a minute to make. I mean, that chicken sandwich they microwave real fast.
How long does it take to make a chicken sandwich? Chicken, lettuce, two slices of tomato, fucking dab of mayonnaise, and a bun.
They've gotten rid of most of the employees now. I mean, this is McDonald's is one of the first like automated.
Yeah.
Almost fully automated. There's having some where it's just robots run the whole goddamn thing.
Well, they need that there. The food, everything. They need that at this one because this was fucking bullshit. Yeah. I was pissed.
Zoinks, man. At least it didn't turn to violence. I mean, we've seen in the videos of people whipping their gat out at those fast food windows, you know?
Yeah. Well, I wasn't.
Hey, pop, 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 pop.
I wasn't that mad. But I did have my pistol with me.
See, you show restraint, and that's why it's okay that you own a weapon. I don't own a weapon for that exact reason. I would shoot everybody.
I had no thoughts of reaching in and grabbing my pistol. I had no thoughts of that.
Good.
I just was very angry, though. I was like, you know, and thankfully I work for myself. But, man, if you were a dude that's out at lunch... And I mean, by the time it was all done, it was like 45, 50 minutes. Right. By the time I actually got my food, I mean, most regular people, they have an hour. They have an hour, and you spent the whole time dicking around in the line at fucking McDonald's.
Right.
How shitty is that?
It surprises me how people they'll tolerate or put up with. Even when I'm doing the flower thing, it's in the same parking lot as a Starbucks.
Mm-hmm.
And it's crazy how far the line of cars go out
around
the corner into the street. It got to the point where the cops were getting involved because it was like starting to block traffic on the main highway.
Mm-hmm.
And they started to make them, I don't know if they gave them tickets or what, but they started making the employees come out of that Starbucks and start taking the orders a little earlier in the line. Another place like that is Chick-fil-A.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Like, what the fuck? Is there crack in there? Like, what would possess someone to sit in a car line for, like, 30 minutes for anything fast food?
Dude, here in Twinsburg, in my town, the worst of the worst, our Starbucks is like that, too. It's really bad. Mm-hmm. But the worst one, Dunkin' Donuts.
Really?
Dunkin', they will have cars, like... You have to come up a main road. It's actually a state route that the Dunkin' is on. It's State Route 82.
Okay.
They will have traffic from a stoplight all the way up to it, which has got to be 3/4 of a mile.
Wow.
The traffic just stops waiting to get in to get a fucking cup of coffee and a, you know, a maple cream donut or whatever. I can't figure it out. I mean, it's, I mean, I definitely have moments where I'm like, yeah, I want to go, because I actually drink Dunkin's coffee. I buy it from Amazon. Right. I drink it.
Yeah.
But there's times when I'm out, especially if I'm out doing my banking early, that I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna run over to Dunkin' and get myself a cup of coffee. Then yeah. I start coming within a mile of it, and the traffic starts like it's a fucking Metallica concert. Weird. It's like, wait a minute, it's fucking coffee.
Yeah, like, you know, and East Coasters are more Dunkin' Donuts people. Like, we, Oceanside, just got our first Dunkin' Donuts this okay. year. And I don't see it even that that busy. There's even another, I'm forgetting the name of this other new coffee shop that went in there. But I would take Dunkin' over Starbucks.
I hate Starbucks coffee. It's terrible.
It's gotten worse, too. I don't know if I'm going crazy or I just make too strong a coffee at home. But I swear they're watering down Starbucks. Like, yeah. There's shrinkflation going on all around where you're getting less of everything. But mm-hmm. I feel like you're getting less coffee grounds in your coffee at Starbucks yeah. now. It just doesn't even get me off.
Starbucks always tasted to me like they strained it through an ashtray. It's a gross tasting coffee.
It was made with like bat shit or something, right?
Yeah, I mean, that was the whole. I don't know.
It's made with. Our coffee beans are grown in bat guano. Yeah, that's why it tastes like that, Chris.
Yeah. I don't know. Chick-fil-A was like that here in Lafayette. Drive-through blocking the road and shit, raisin. Yeah.
Was it anything to do with, like, Chick-fil-A? Like, don't they have, like, views on life? You know, like, aren't they, like, Christian, like, hardcore Christian people? Or there's something going on with them? Oh, yeah,
they are. They definitely are that. But... No, it's because they have a fucking great sandwich.
Is it? I never.
Their sandwich is really fucking good. I will swear by it. I don't eat it very often because there's not one near me. But if I'm traveling somewhere, which is almost never, and there's a Chick-fil-A that's open, and it's not a million people in line, I will stop. I will stop.
I'll take Jack in the Box any day.
Jack in the Box, okay. I'll tell you. Here's another one that make you crazy with the fast food restaurants. And this is only in my stupid town of Twinsburg. And my daughter told me why this is. So there's a Burger King in my town. And the way it's set up is you drive all the way to the back of the Burger King. And that's where the ordering thing is. And then you kind of come around the curve. And then you go up to the front and you pay. It's one window to pay. And then there's one window to get your food. Okay, at the Burger King. But when you order your food at the Burger King now, they tell you to wait there until they tell you to come down. Hmm. Would you like to guess why they do that?
No. Yes. No. Tell me. I don't want to guess.
I had no idea. And it just annoys me to no end, because why am I sitting there? You know, why am I sitting there? I should be sitting up where it's faster to get my fucking food. My daughter clued me in on this because she works for DoorDash.
Okay.
The Burger King instituted some sort of a device that measures the time a car is in front of the food service window. Oh. And they ding them on the corporate level if they have a percentage over a certain time.
Wow.
So these fucking cheese dicks make you sit out at the order station so that their time is always their time is always like 15 seconds. Because they tell you to drive down when the food is ready.
Well, knowing that, you should just not wait. Just drive up just to fuck with you. Better hurry up, motherfucker.
Now I will do
Corporate's going to see.
Now, from now on, I'll be like, oh, I didn't hear you say that. Fuck you. Because I don't want to sit out there. You know, I just don't. And I know it's dumb. I guess it really doesn't make any difference. But fuck them. Stop being stoners and do your goddamn job.
Right.
You know? That's where I am with that, but
it's called fast food for a reason. Hurry up!
Yeah, well, it is. Dude, I went to a fast food place today and sat for 50 fucking minutes before I got my food.
Only on the road do I have to, you know, get fast food. I would never do that here. You know me, I'm Chef Fiorentinos over here.
Yes,
you
know? With your cum semen.
Actually, I thought of you. I got a pretty gnarled burn. Let me take my jacket. I got a gnarly bird cooking the other day. I made these amazing pork chops.
Right.
The other day. And then look at this. You can see it. Yeah.
Youch.
It doesn't look that bad, but if you were looking at it here, it's kind of gnarly. But I was muscling out the pork chops out of the oven. They were in a glass thing, and I breaded olive oil, done up nice. Anyway, pulled it out, and then I was reaching for something else with my other hand as I was pulling it out, and I just went, "What's that smell? Is that the pork chops?" No, it's my arm. So I have a permanent, looks like a triangle or a piece of pizza or something.
Is this where I'm supposed to say, "Oh, poor baby," when we're talking about burns? When we're talking about burns?
It. Blow on it, daddy.
And somehow I don't have a lot of compassion for burns. Oh, you got a burn on your arm? That's nice.
Every time I get a little burn, I go, "I thought of you, Chris."
And with that said, you ought to buy this book right here. Call Me Chris, a burn book about surviving it.
That's right.
All right, let's get the fuck out of here, shall we?
Let's do it, man. That was fun.
That was fun. A lot of fun. Next week on the show, a band that I love, and you have no idea who, but I will send you their music. Pissing Razors will be here. I know you don't know who they are.
I've pissed a few razors.
Yes, I bet you have.
No, I'll look them up. I'll check them
They out. Are they're a band from Texas. They were, to me, they were my Pantera when Pantera was between records. And they're back, and they're playing, and I saw them a couple weeks ago, and they fucking killed. So that was cool. And then, not confirmed, but I'm trying to confirm it right now, Miss Janet Gardner from Vixen.
Oh, wow, great.
Will probably be with us as well. We're trying to line up the schedule to make it work. But if we can make that work, Janet Gardner will be with us next week as well, so we can talk about her new solo record and her days in Vixen and all that kind of stuff. So
now, are we allowed to talk about the hurricane too?
What hurricane?
The hurricane.
Yeah, we can talk. Yeah,
N-word. Hurricane N-word.
Nita. You want to say that? You want to say that? People take it to an entirely different meaning.
Yeah, we're allowed to say it.
Eric and I will be interviewing Miss Nita Strauss live on Saturday, exclusively on our Locals page. So if you are a subscriber to Locals, you can watch that interview live, and I'm sure we'll put it out at some point, but it will be live on the Locals page, and to sign up for that, it's just classicmetalshow.locals.com, and it's at 12:30 Eastern, 9:30 your time on Saturday. That'll be cool.
Yeah, absolutely. We're getting ladies on the show now.
We are.
It's not a total dude, you know, sword fight going on here on the
Crusade. And certainly hot ones, because my goodness.
Hot ones, right?
My goodness, Bella's hot, and certainly Nita Strauss. Oh, my goodness. Right. That's a good-looking lady.
Yeah, we're just like, go on, Bella.
Yeah, exactly. Keep talking. Keep.
I was checking out, now that I switched to like a professional Facebook or whatever, I get more insights and stuff like that. And apparently my fan base is pretty much down the middle. I have like a 50-50 male-female fan base. One thing that I found interesting, you know, my, hold on one sec, Chris. Hang on one sec.
I don't know where Eric's going, but. There he is.
Last week, I didn't know if I went too far because our show was brought to you by Hodges Suntan Lotion. Right. But mostly women laughed at that.
Oh, really?
I got more. Yeah, I was a little worried. I thought I went a little too far with that. I know my family was a little
worried. No, please. On that one. Please. But,
if it wasn't for Hodges, none of us would be here.
That's right. Know? That's right.
But it was funny that a lot of women found it funny.
I'm like glad women are looking at your channel. Let me tell you, the CMS channels are like 98%, 2%.
2% women?
2% women, yeah.
Well, that's why I got brought into the mix, Chris.
That's why, bring in the female crowd.
Yeah,
watch a little Nita Strauss, shall we?
All right.
This is her latest video with Dorothy, another hottie. So here we go. Nita Strauss. Anita Strauss is a good-looking lady. My goodness. Yeah, you're going to have to ask all the questions.
Just guitar questions.
I'm just going to be like, Nita, hi.
Right. Well, you'll know I'll be being polite. I mean,
yeah, I'll be polite. I've interviewed Nita before. She's great. She really is great.
I'm not going to lie. I did imagine doing the interview as Exploder.
No, don't do that.
You would totally bum out. We have to gain the trust.
It'd be like
a few more females before we go Exploder on them.
It'd be like, oh, look, Eric just popped out of the scene for a minute.
Yeah, then I'm back. Hey, I haven't seen a girl in like a long
time. Oh, what happened? Eric just fell out of the screen again.
Careful. Have I thought about you?
Yeah, Nita's a good-looking lady and fucking super talented, and I am very excited to be talking to Nita on Saturday. So, Nita Strauss, Saturday, join us, classicmetalshow.locals.com, and you can not only be on there to watch it, but we might take a question or two, depending on how much time Nita has with us. I don't know how much time she has with us, but...
Bella spent a lot of time with us, so she was totally fair and nice. And
Yeah, she was great. She was fantastic. She just hung out. You know, she was... We were fortunate with her that she's not, like, doing an interview schedule. Dude, that was the weirdest thing with her. I literally just found an email address and emailed her. I just threw an email, and she hit me back. It's like, yeah, I'd love to do your show. It's like, okay, cool. That was easy. You know, I didn't have to deal with management.
Right.
It's always the best when you just go directly with the artist, because then it actually happens where
a lot
of times with the management, you're booked to do it, and then it's like, oh, well, we got a scheduling change, and it's like, yeah, okay.
Not somebody everybody has management. Remember, like, agents and managers, those are two separate entities.
I know, but...
take, like, 10 to 15% of your pay. Mm. So people figure out pretty quick what they need and don't need. I mean, most people contact me direct, you know, on social media for interviews. And...
Absolutely. But, all right, we're getting out of here. My arm is falling off a little bit, so... Great show, as always. We will be back next week. We'll be doing it again. We'll be back on Saturday with Nita Strauss. For those of you that are a Nita Strauss fan or an Alice Cooper fan, or you want to find out about that whole Demi Lovato shortcut that she took, and then now she's back with Alice Cooper, I will definitely be asking her that question. Mm-hmm. So that's what's on the table. Eric, great as always. And we're done. Bye, kids.
Bye, everybody.